everybody, and it's great to be here. I'm at Art Clinus. I want to start by introducing and thanking the person at the end of the camera, who's Katrina Black. So thank you, Katrina, for giving up your time to do this. We're at Art Clinus, and we are not far from the coast. We are about 2 miles south of Waterfoot, 20 miles south of Ballycastle, and 5 miles north of Carnlough. Sounds a bit like a geography lesson, this, doesn't it? And we're about one field away from the coast, so it hasn't been a long Lenten walk for us. So Art Clinus is it comes from the Irish, which means high slope, and over on my right there are cliffs and quite steep ground, so that's the kind of that's, you know, what the meaning of Art Clinus is. The earliest date that I'm aware of on this site is 508, and that is when this was founded. And it was founded by St. McNeice, who was a bishop of this monastic area here. I think it was called a see. And St. McNeice, although this church isn't known to everyone around here, everybody will be familiar with St. McNeice's, which is what the college near here was called until recently. Obviously this church existed for centuries and is documented in the annals, but by the end of the 17th century, 1657 actually, it was described as ruinated. And it kind of looks pretty ruinated at the minute as well. So, and then we have a long period of time, centuries really, when there was no church or church building along this coast. But it would still have been covered by, itinerant priests or itinerant preachers who were, you know, going along the coast. And what I love about this story is that these itinerant priests or ministers would have been happy to baptize whoever had been born in the intervening years. And so there was a pretty eclectic approach to ministry in those days, which I think is just great kind of thing. Okay, so as you can see, I'm sitting in one of the pews now, you'll know that the theme of this year's Lenten walks is journeying, and that's very appropriate for here, because people would have journeyed to get to this church, people would have journeyed along this coast, and this was before the coast road, so any of that would have been really challenging. In fact, so much so that for centuries it would have been easier in many ways to cross the sea to Scotland than to go from here to Ballycastle. So journeying was any minister that would have come here would have had to journey and would have had a challenging journey along this coast. So I've got a prayer here which I'm going to read out just on journeying. God, go with us on our journey. Revive us when we are weary. Direct us when we go astray. Inspire us when we lose heart. Reprove us when we turn back. Keep us travelling ever onwards, a pilgrim people looking to Jesus Christ, who has run the race before us and who waits to welcome us home. Of course, the thing about journeying is that it isn't always a physical journey. Obviously, we think of physical journeys at the minute with the journeys that key workers are doing, the journeys of refugees and asylum seekers, But journeys can also be a journey of the mind, of faith, of longing, of forgiveness, or of joy. Katrina and I have now journeyed along the coast, the East Antrim coast, and we are in Carnlough. We're not actually right in the middle of Carnlough, we're about half a mile outside of it, but I'm standing outside the new Artlinus Church. I say new, it was built in, I think it was the late 1830s, but it was consecrated in 1841, so it's been in use from then continuously through to about a year ago. That's kind of when lockdown happened. And I remember sitting in a pew and saying to the person in front of me, I wonder will we be here next Sunday? And he kind of looked at me as much as say, well, why wouldn't we be? And in fact, that's the way it was. So we've come inside the church. And there's something that I want to point out just where we are inside. On the wall at the back, and Katrina's going to pan round to it now, there is a picture of the Artlinus Crozier. And the Artlinus Crozier was a pastoral staff which was located on a windowsill in the old church that we visited earlier on. It was made of bronze, silver and oak. I say was, it still is, but it's not here and it's not there, it's now in the National Museum of Dublin. So, but that's a kind of a link between the two churches. A crozier is, like I said, it's a pastoral staff and it reminds us of the reassurance of God and also of keeping us on the path, keeping us on the journey. And during this last year, I have missed being here. I've missed worshipping here. And in particular, one of the things that I've missed is one of the morning collects, which will be familiar to people who know the Church of Ireland. It's a morning collect and it's a collect of guidance. And before we say it, when I'm reading the lesson, I ask people to think first of all about what the coming week holds for them, whether it's to do with school or whether it's work or family meetings that they have or an appointment or something like that. And we kind of take a moment to just think about that, and then we stay together the morning collect. Heavenly Father, in whom we live and move and have our being, we humbly pray that your Holy Spirit may so guide and govern us that in all the cares and occupations of our daily life, we may never forget your presence, but may remember that we are always walking in your sight, through Jesus Christ our Lord. So there is a reassurance in that prayer. So I want to thank you for coming along with me today to Artlinus. I hope you have a good week. And I'm going to close with a blessing, which is the Aaronic blessing. May the Lord bless us and keep us.
May the Lord make his face to shine upon us and be gracious unto us. And may the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon us and give us his peace, now and always. Amen.